So today, I will try to intro about the mirror in the Photoshop. Something on my head, the accessory there. They have to use some kind of the copy and paste. That is enough. So let's open our mirror first. So let's open character. There's some of the texture which we have to copy and paste first. First, we have to select the hair editor, which is here. Okay, so choose the hair editor. And now, for me, I have to do the new input. So just add freehand group. First, you have to draw something like this, which maybe you are targeting here. Okay, so they have two kinds of making the accessory of the head. Today I will just intro for one of them. So here, first you have already drawn a hair, it will appear there. So now you have to simply just click something here, then click a duplicate. So that you can duplicate a hair texture. So here, you can select for the just select the texture here. So mostly the last one is the one you have duplicate. Then you select the default image. So this one should be the one you duplicate just now. So you can see this one is my here. This is the accessory for the headband. I will just click the default image, right click, then you click export. After that export, then you can go inside any of the folder. You just have to paste inside, okay? So I will name this one as new ribbon. Okay, so save. After that, you can go to the Google or anything. Search a ribbon that you like. So I just simply choose one. So maybe like this one. Remember, the copyright is very important. So some of the image have copyright, maybe you have to aware of it. Like me, I will just try to, for today's tutorial, I will just copy one of the image. So I will copy this one. Copy the image. Okay, you already clicked the copy the image. So next, you have to open your Photoshop, then go to the folder just now you have created the image file. So you just create it, then draw inside the Photoshop. So this is your template. So this is the template of the head. First, you have to wipe up the thing. So just left an empty one. Then you Control V, then you can pause the image just now you have copied. So this is maybe this one is the ribbon you wish to paste like on the hair. There is two methods you can crop the image. The first one is quite easy. If the image have a very beautiful outline, you can choose a bone and the Photoshop here, which name as Magic Warp. Then you can just click it, then delete it. Then you can have a very pretty outline here. In case, okay, sometimes in case you have a very rough kind of outline. Yeah, the image which I wish to use one is very rough. So if the image very rough, you can use the polygon. So for you this one, you can just select it, the outline, so that actually this kind of effect is same as the magic wand. But since like the outline is quite pretty, so you can just click the use the magic wand and delete it. Okay, so now you have the ribbon. The ribbon which you already cropped up, as me, I will try to use the this outside the ruler from the Photoshop. If you not have the ruler, you just go, then the ruler will come up, or you just go upstairs. I think it's, yeah, inside the view, then you click the ruler. Then you can grab the guideline. So I want to find the middle line of the template. So this one is the middle line of the template. Now you can select the image which is just not already cropped up. First you have the string or resize by the Ctrl R. This is a transform tools. So now you can just create it, then make it smaller. At least smaller than the middle line. Okay? So after that you have to pull a little bit longer for the ribbon. So that later you can use in the V-Roid. Okay? So for the V-Roid, the shape should be like this. So let's save Ctrl S. After that, you can open the V-Roid. So this is our file. This is our texture which just now we have been output. So now we have to import the ribbon just now you have sent on the Photoshop. Don't forget, they have to be PNG file so that they have a transparent background. So now you have already get a ribbon. Yeah, but the shape still very weird. So now what can you do? Now you have to select, go to design here, then go to the group just now you have been let create just now, the hair. So this one is the hair, but we can do the effect for the ribbon. So first of all, I will do this graph. You will see this graph. I will pull all the line go up. So the interface of the hair will become flat. Become the flat, that means can use the photo can cut. Become flat, the photo can be cut up. Then I will turn down the thickness. Then I will increase the white. So now this is the most important part. Now you can choose the texture position by control the width here. So you can see it's quite become a variable shape. But now you can just try to find one position that is okay for her. Okay, so now you can use the offset, turn the things, because somehow this one is the 3D shape. So this one is the behind of the 3D. Now you have pull here, this become the at the front. So when this is at the front, but now you can find the ribbon still a bit distorted. So how can you fix the distorted? You have to pull this one, the highlight position. So you just drag it go out or something. Then you try to turn the model around by using the right click. So you can turn around, you will see that actually now this is okay. Yeah, this is not bad, but it's okay. So the ribbon is being made. So you found that the ribbon is not that, it looks so flat now. So this is the problem. How can we solve that? So we have to, because the ribbon is surrounded at the with this transparent tube which is here. So you just try to grab it. This one have to get used to it. Try to explore it. Don't feel that is something make it too ugly or something. I think we have to try it. So now you can see it's still a bit not that natural. So I try to move it. Even use the control point, you can try to make it. Try to grab it. Then later it will look more natural. Okay. So yeah. So now this is the ribbon. most of the time, the model we will just look at the front, but when the texture is behind, how can you solve the problem? Is the tools you can use, which is here position X and position Y. So the most important thing is the position X, you see, and drag it so that it will go to the front. I had my hair clip first. This kind of style, which is quite not suitable for this kind of you wish to enlarge the ribbon, it will become a problem for that. So for this one, I think I will just make the ribbon smaller so that it will become more natural at the model. Yeah, you can see that it will more natural. Yeah, this one will look more natural for this kind of style. Okay, so if you want to make something like duplicate it, have more ribbon like A, B, C, three of the ribbon, so you can just create the duplicate, then you use the X, no, use the Y to move the ribbon so that it will going down. Okay, so I just try to drag another one so that I have three ribbon. Okay, there's three ribbon. So this one is one of the style. The strong part for this kind of style of the accessory on the hair is that this is more simple than you have to mark all the accessory for the hair. But this one, you can very easily create any picture on where you want, then you just press it. So the weird part is, you can see it is very, very flat. It is look non-natural at all. But remake it smaller or mini so that it can become not that strong vision, so that not people will see it is unnatural. There's another type of the ribbon, like this type. But I will make it as another tutorial. So maybe next time I will intro this kind of ribbon. This kind of ribbon is more flexible, which is you can see it can be they have a movement on the ribbon. Okay, so this is the tutorial for the making the ribbon for the hair. So this is today's tutorial. Thank you. See you. Bye.